Could these fishermen be amongst the last people to have seen flight MH370? The night it went missing, Azid Ibrahim and his friend had taken a group of people night fishing off the coast of northeast Malaysia from a town called Kota Baru out into the South China Sea. I took the boat out with them to find out more about what he'd seen. I was fishing when I saw the plane. It looks strange, flying low, Azid tells me. I told my friend that's not normal. Normally it flies at 35,000 feet, but that night it touched the clouds. I thought the pilot must be crazy. We don't know if that plane is flight MH370, but the time the fishermen saw a plane flying surprisingly low is around the same time the air traffic controllers lose contact with the plane, 1:30 a.m. And it's above the South China Sea, between Malaysia and Vietnam, that the missing plane last identified itself as flight MH370. How clearly could you see the plane? What could you see on it? It was really low. Normally, the lights look really small, but this time they were really big, like the size of a coconut. The plane and those on board still haven't been found. It's still not known what happened on board. But if there was an emergency, could the plane have made a turn to make an emergency landing? This is the nearest airport to the last known location of flight MH370. Kota Baru Airport also has a runway that's 2,400 metres, that's nearly 7,900 feet long. Long enough for a 777 to land in. The fishermen filed a police report about the low-flying plane. It's not known if that report is being used by investigators in the capital to add another piece to the puzzle. That is the disappearance of flight MH370. Saima Mohsin, CNN, Kota Baru, Malaysia.